This is Jared Horak for today's racingdigest.com, and my today's Racing Digest video series continues Saturday, February 2nd, 2019. We're going to look at the three Kentucky Derby 2019 points races that are on the schedule. Before that, we've been doing well with our videos recently. I'll go back to January 19th, a couple weeks ago. We had first Premio from Fairgrounds win a stakes race as our top choice. And then last weekend, Bricks and Mortar from Gulfstream Park winning the Pegasus World Cup Turf as our top choice there on January 26th. So now we're going for our third video winner in a row. Hopefully we can get some more video winners this week in these Kentucky Derby points races. And if you want to read my Kentucky Derby blogs, you can read those each and every week at todaysracingdigest.com. Now let's jump into the three points races for February 2nd. We'll start with Aqueduct, and it'll be the ninth race from Aqueduct, the Grade 3 Withers. And they're going to be traveling a mile and an eighth on the main track. We have a 7-horse field in here. Number one, Tax, is your morning line favorite at 2-1. He stepped up from a maiden claiming victory to run in the Remsen Stakes last time out, and he ended up finishing a solid third in that Remsen Stakes at 17-1. He was in the hunt throughout, but now he's not going to be 17-1. He's a 2-1 favorite. I'm going to try to beat him in here. I wouldn't be surprised if he ran well. He's bred to run a route of ground. He ran okay in the Remsen, and he should save ground. He should be up on the pace in here. Some others to look at: number five, Lucky Lee, shipping in from Parks, where he won back-to-back 1 mile races there to end his juvenile campaign, and he should be up on the pace as well. Another one to look at: number six, Our Brain Trust. Now, I liked him last time out. He was clearly second best in the Jerome Stakes. Now Mark Cassie has taken over the training duties for this one. This one was based in Maryland before his last race. I don't really know how far he wants to go. I'm not sure he wants to run a mile and an eighth. I think his best chance is to sit back, make a late run, and try to pass some tired horses. But he's 6-1. The price isn't bad, but I'm just not sure he wants to go this far. And then finally, number seven, Not That Brady, 4-1 morning line. He's a New York bred. He's got speed. Look for him to try to play catch me if you can. Don't know if he wants to go this far. But the horse that I'm going to put on top in this race is going to be number three, Moretti, 3-1 morning line for trainer Todd Pletcher. And they paid $900,000 for this one. And in his second career start at Aqueduct at the 9-furlong distance, he broke his maiden stalking the pace, and he earned an improved 128 CPR. The CPR for today's Racing Digest is the comprehensive performance rating, which takes into account pace, final time and closing fraction, and he earned a 125 final rating. And also, in his final fraction, he had a field best 36.9 seconds in his last fraction. So he looks like the best finisher in this race, should get pace to chase, he should save ground, he's adding blinkers in this spot. As I said, he'll probably stalk the pace, he'll pounce from mid-pack, and maybe he'll offer a hint of value as the second choice on the morning line. Let's jump over to Gulfstream Park. Their 11th race, the Grade 2 Holy Bull, a mile and a 16th on the main track. Your morning line favorite is number 8, Maximus Mischief. He's even money on the morning line. He won all three of his juvenile starts easily, his first two at Parks. Then he shipped to Aqueduct for the Remsen Stakes. The pace wasn't fast. He was up on that pace throughout, and he won that one nicely. So now he's going to make his three-year-old debut. He's been training well, but there are more horses with speed in this race. There are multiple horses that are capable of showing speed, especially the two horses breaking from the outside post positions. So Maximus Mischief this time may have to end up taking up a stalking position. Jose Ortiz is going to ride, and he should be prominent throughout, but he's not going to offer any value. Mijos, number six, 5-2 morning line. Drew a good post in here. He got a great setup in the Mucho Macho Man. I liked him in that race on January 5th. The pace was fast. He ran well, and he mowed him down in the lane, just grinded out a nice win. Now he's going to run two turns for the first time. The pace should be quick again. He's going to be grinding away. John Velasquez is going to ride. Now the horse that I want to play on top here, again, the Todd Pletcher trainee, number two, Federal Case. He's 6-1 morning line. He's run two times, and he won both of those races. His first start, he won at 7 furlongs, and then in a one-turn mile in his second start, that was a nice victory against three rivals. That was at Gulfstream Park, and that day, Frosted Grace set the pace, and Federal Case chased him throughout. Looked like Frosted Grace might win that one, but Federal Case in late stretch was able to wear him down and win nicely. He got an improved 90 fire number, the fire number for today's Racing Digest, speed throughout a race. He got a 119 CPR and a 132 final rating. They paid $650,000 for this son of gemologist. And with that inside post and that tactical speed, he could sit a great ground-saving stalking trip under his new rider, Javier Castellano. Finally, let's jump over to the sixth race at Santa Anita, the Grade 3 Robert Lewis Stakes, a mile and a 1/16 on the main track. And we're going to have a six-horse field in here. And your morning line favorite is number 5, Mucho Gusto, 8-5 morning line, trainer Bob Baffert. Now, last time, Savagery, in that Los Alamitos Futurity, he blew the first turn, but Mucho Gusto wasn't involved in that incident. He was able to steer clear. He set the pace that day, and he was clearly second best. His stablemate won that one, Improbable. He stayed out of trouble as well. He dominated that one. Mucho Gusto was second best. The show finisher in there, Extra Hope, he came back and won an optional claiming a dirt route at Santa Anita on a wet track on January 31st. So this one could be the controlling speed under Joe Talamo. His best chance might be to get out there and try to wire the field. We could have a wet track at Santa Anita. Some others to consider in here, number 4, Gunmetal Gray, your second choice, 9-5 morning line. He got a great setup in the Sham Stakes. That race set up for a closer. He closed to win that one. I don't think the pace is going to be nearly as fast this time. And there's also a chance that, as I said, there could be a wet track. A lot of times, wet tracks are speed favoring in California. He's going to take more money than he should as a closer up against the pace scenario here. Magnificent McCool, number 2, he switched back to the turf last time out, and he relaxed and broke his maiden. He liked to get out to the front earlier in his career. He stuck the pace. He broke the maiden on turf. He's moving back to dirt today. Flavian Pratt, 4-5 with trainer Doug O'Neill recently. I wouldn't be surprised with an inner post that they tried to go to the lead in here. But I'm going to go with number 6, Nolo Contesto. He's 5-2 morning line, his career debut in a 10-horse field in a sprint race, breaking from the inside post. He had a troubled trip, ended up finishing 5th. Then they stretched him out in distance. Second career start at Santa Anita. From the outside post, he stalked the pace, 1-mile race, January 4th. Won that one nicely, getting an improved 90 fire number, a 126 CPR, and a 132 final rating. Again, he's got the outside post. Joao Rosario, John Sadler, they've been winning races together recently. It's going to sit a good trip in the clear, stalking the pace. He should have every chance to run down Mucho Gusto. So my top 3 horses for these 3 stakes races. In the Wither Stakes, I'm taking number 3, Moretti. In the Holy Bull, I'm taking number 2, Federal Case. And in the Robert Lewis, I'm taking number 6, Nolo Contesto. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, make some comments in the comments section. Who do you like in these 3 Kentucky Derby 2019 points races? If you're interested in the complete digests for Aqueduct, Gulfstream Park, and Santa Anita Park for Saturday, February 2nd, you can find all of those at todaysracingdigest.com, along with my full card analysis from Santa Anita Park each and every day for Saturday, February 2nd. All the races from Santa Anita Park, including the Pick 6 carryover, mandatory payout for that Rainbow 6 at Santa Anita, plus bonus stakes races from around the country, Aqueduct, Gulfstream, Santa Anita stakes races, and some other stakes races from Oaklawn Park as well. You can find all of that at todaysracingdigest.com. That will wrap up this week's video. Be back next week with another stakes race from around the country.